Welcome to O Channel O Health. I'm your nutritionist Wen Xin.
And I'm your dietitian Jeremy.
Jeremy, today we're going to talk about heart. You know that every year on the 29th of September is a World Heart Day.
Okay.
And today I'm going to talk about heart, but for Chinese, lah, most of us when we talk about heart, we think of your Fu Xing Han, lah, this kind of emotional thing. Even in English proverb, they have words like follow your heart, my heartscape a bit. But anatomically, our heart is not really that related to emotion. Instead, it was the brain, isn't it?
Yes, correct.
Yeah, so the function of our heart is to pump the blood throughout our body when the heart beats.
Yeah. Yes. So if let's say we have seen in the market the fresh red heart, right? So the red heart sometimes we see is pumping. So the pumping, why we need to pump, why our heart need to pump the blood is because we need the blood to be circulated to all the parts in our body so that our cells, our tissues, our muscles will have the energy and the blood supply. And same thing goes to when we exercise. So our heartbeat goes up, right? Or when we feel nervous, so our heartbeat also goes up. Why? Because there will be more blood supply being pumped to the entire body.
Yeah, but today's our topic will be heart attack. Yeah, for those who don't know, heart attack actually is also known as the myocardial infarction.
Okay.
It happens when our blood supply to our heart being cut up, being blocked. Blocked by what? Actually, it's mostly it's the plaque. Plaque is a waxy, kind of fatty and cholesterol substance. It will build up around your heart, your blood arteries,
vessels.
Yeah, and when it build out, it form the clot.
Okay.
Yeah, when the clot become bigger, one day when it block entirely the heart, the blood vessel to your heart, then you will have the heart attack.
Yeah, it's just for a very simple explanation. For example, let's say we have water pipings in our home, right? And then, you know, over 10, 20 or 30 years, and then the pipe become very rusty, and then we will start to form like, those rusty material inside the pipe, alright? And then sometimes when, you know, in slango, we always have the water cut, right? So after the water cut, and then the water resume, and then the first thing when we open the pipe, what we see is all
yellowish,
rusty material. So this actually all the rust that forms within the piping. So over time, if let's say this happens in our heart, okay, when we eat our high fat food, la chao kway tiao kari mi bak kut teh, you know, all these high fat food eventually they forms a lot of these cholesterol deposits in our blood vessels. So our blood vessels, right, very very tiny only, and then when you put in all this material to clog the arteries or the blood vessels, eventually when it clogs, what will happen? It will burst. Because the pressure is too high, it cannot withstand, then it will actually burst. When it bursts in our heart, it will form the heart attack. If it bursts in the brain, it will form the stroke. So this is actually quite a common scenario in Malaysia. Why? Because according to a news article published in 2019, okay, actually, do you know that 50 Malaysians actually die from heart disease every single day?
Wow.
Yeah, so it's actually one of the main cause of death last year, and it's actually make up of 16%, okay, and it's even higher when in compared to 2017, it was only 17%, so 14%. So we can see that there is a gradual increase of death due to heart disease.
Yeah, right? But heart attack, heart disease, normally on our general perception now, we always related to the drama TV scene, very dramatic. Yeah, it will like fall down in seconds. But actually, the symptoms for heart attack may vary. It can have a different severity, different symptoms, especially when it comes to gender, like men and women, we do have a different kinds of symptoms.
Yeah, so what are the difference in terms of men and women? Okay, how do we know possibly we may have some kind of symptoms that could be related to heart disease? Let us see.
Yeah, let us see.
In men, okay, we start with men first, okay? So we have men, for example, they may have nausea, vomiting, okay, not due to food poisoning. And then you also notice that there's a pain in the jawline, neck, or even back pain. Sometimes people actually relate to the left side. For example, there's only a one-sided pain across the from the neck, the jawline, up to the shoulder, or even the arm. It could be one of the symptoms of the heart attack. And also, there could be a squeezing chest pressure or pain. It's like something, someone squeeze your chest, alright, and having that kind of pain. So excruciating, and it's very sharp pain, alright. And thus it could be shortness of breath, okay, because we know our heart pumps the blood to the entire body. So when your heart no longer able to pump, that's where you may not be able to breathe properly, okay. You may be gasping for air and then you start to feel your breath getting shorter, okay, and shallower. So that's where these are the signs and symptoms for men. Now, yeah. What happens in women?
So for women, actually, we have more symptoms compared to men.
Mm-hmm.
Like similarity is the nausea or vomiting.
Okay.
And we also have jaw, neck, or upper back pain.
Mm-hmm.
And we also include the chest pain, but not always. Yeah, actually,
okay.
Chest pain is not always the symptoms for
of
ladies.
Heart attack,
yeah.
Right?
And then we have pain or pressure in the lower chest or even upper abdomen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes it's not actually our stomach pain.
Yeah.
It's the heart attack symptoms.
Okay.
And then we also have shortness of breath, including fainting, indigestion, and extreme fatigue. I think these three are the very kind of
common.
Misleading symptoms. Sometimes we might think it's our stomach problem, mm-hmm. our GI tract problem, but mm-hmm. actually they are also symptoms of you are getting a heart attack.
Yes, correct. So all in all, okay, actually the summary is we do not just rely on one symptom and then you say you have heart attack. Of course, it could be a few symptoms coming all together. And then the easiest thing for you to do is quickly to get a medical checkup or medical treatment to check out to find out whether is it true you really have the heart disease, because only doctors will tell from your echogram and then they will actually find out whether you have the symptoms or you are going through a heart attack.
Yeah,
right?
So heart attacks is not always the sudden or emergency symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes that you might have these kind of symptoms happen in maybe few hours earlier,
yes,
few
correct.
Days earlier, few weeks earlier.
Yes, correct. So when the heart disease, because we know that our heart, okay, we have the three main blood vessels. So sometimes it could be the two main blood vessels being clogged. So you already have some symptoms, for example, shortness of breath. Okay, you feel very heavy, you're very very draggy, you know, you walk,
yeah.
So you feel very tired. So this could have been happened for the past 24 to 48 hours. So do not assume or do not take it very lightly, because it could actually lead you to one of the very serious episode of heart attack, alright? So now that we have learned this signs and symptoms, so what are the risk factors, okay? How do we know, okay, we have this risk of getting this heart disease?
Yeah.
Mm.
So actually for risk factors, we can divide them into two.
Mm-hmm.
One is the risk factor that you cannot control.
Okay.
Another one is you can control.
Okay, so what are the ones that we cannot control?
Yeah, for those we cannot control is aging.
Mm-hmm.
When we're getting older, we can easily get a lot of disease, including heart disease.
Yes,
for
because,
example, mm-hmm. yeah, for men, it's like over 55 years
mm-hmm.
old, for women, over 65 years old.
Yes, because normally for why there's a gender difference, because women inherently they have a higher female hormone called
yes.
the estrogen and progesterone. So these hormones are actually protective against cholesterol level, against heart disease risk factors. But as they progress to menopause, okay, like above 50 years old, and that's where these side effects will start to come in, and then the risk factor for getting heart disease will become higher.
Yeah. Mm. Next one, we have family history. So
mm-hmm.
if you have your first degree relative from the male and female side, for
mm-hmm.
example, your father, your mother,
mm-hmm.
brother, sister are having an early heart disease, you might having also a higher risk of getting into heart attack.
Yeah, so this is the same thing with when you have one high, two high, or even three highs, for example, the high cholesterol, high blood pressure, or high blood sugar level. If one of your close relatives, that means like your brother, sisters, your siblings, and then your parents, okay, already having this kind of issues, then you also have a higher risk of getting this health problem as well. So the next also we have gender.
Yeah, gender. Mm. Actually, male is like having two times more risk compared to female, because just like Jeremy mentioned just now,
yes.
female, before they're having the menopause, we have the protection effect from estrogen or
yes,
female
correct.
Hormones.
So not to say, of course, men, in consideration that you may have other risk factors, for example, smoking, you know,
mm-hmm,
drinking
yeah.
alcohol, experiencing high stress from work. So these actually can come together to lead you to have higher risk of heart disease or heart attack. So we have talked about those that we cannot control. So
yeah.
now these are the things that we can control.
So don't feel despair whenever,
mm.
Just now you heard that you cannot control this, but most of the risk factors that we can control,
mm-hmm.
for example, like our lifestyle, smoking, drinking alcohol mm-hmm. actually will increase our risk of getting the heart attack
mm-hmm.
and also high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, this known as the three highs.
Three highs, correct. So this imagine for example when you have high cholesterol, that's where you have your blood vessels, yeah, your internal water piping mm-hmm. become clogged, okay, by the cholesterol deposits. Okay, if you have diabetes, it will actually affect the structure of your blood vessels, okay? It will actually damage the smaller blood vessels, especially in the eyes, okay, for in the legs and etc. And also we have high blood pressure, it will also stiffen up, okay, your blood vessels. So it actually makes your blood vessels less elastic. So when your blood pressure goes up, mm-hmm. blood, your blood vessels remain the same size, okay? So imagine the pressure the blood is going through, and the blood vessels is going through, and eventually it will actually burst as well. So if you have already have one of these, okay, three highs, it's very important for you to control so that it doesn't lead you to more complications later on.
Yeah, next one we have being overweight or obese. So actually those who are overweight or obese, they are having a higher risk of these three highs. That's
yes.
why it also have a higher risk of getting heart attack.
Yes, and we know Malaysia boleh, because we have been rated the only country in Southeast Asia with the highest prevalence of overweight and obesity. That's like almost 50%. That means one out of 2% already having these weight issues, and it's a very serious concern. Even children also are having these overweight and obese issues.
Okay, next we have lack of exercise. We know that nowadays youngsters or even elders, we have a sedentary lifestyle. We always stick to our electronical mobile devices, laptops, smartphones, and we don't sitting in our sofa watching TV, watching Netflix.
Yeah, the couch potato. So on top of that, somehow now we have the RMCO. Previously we have the MCO. So we were actually forced to actually sit at home. And not many of us have the initiative to actually exercise because you don't find it comfortable exercising at home.
Yeah.
And then you're not allowed to go out to exercise due to the movement constraint. So the only thing you do at home was, you know, just sitting down, watching TV, eating junk foods, okay, eating snacks, okay, non-stop eating. So that's where it actually put you even at higher risk. Even since now that we are going through the RMCO, many people still have the sedentary lifestyle.
Yeah, even you have a yoga mat at your home, but you still don't feel motivated to get started.
So that's the issue. And then you start putting on more bigger numbers on your waistline.
Yeah.
Right.
Next, we have stress. Yeah, stress is quite a common problem amongst working adults right now.
Yes, correct. So we know that stress comes in every form, whether at work, at home, okay, you quarrel with your husband, quarrel with your wife, quarrel with your children, you know, scolding your children for not doing their work, and then going to work, maybe you're facing a tight deadlines, and then somehow now people still working from home. Okay, when you work from home, then you actually have longer working hours unknowingly, alright? So going through this actually makes you stress, and stress actually makes you have a lot of these sad hormones in your body. Okay, this hormone actually trigger a lot of this inflammation in our body and makes you even more prone to heart attack also.
Yeah, and for those people who are having stress, normally they also have a bad lifestyle, bad behaviors.
Yeah.
You know, when you are stressed working in the office, when you go back home, you don't feel like want to exercise, you would like want to snacking, just sit down, maybe drinking alcohol, to manage your stress away. You think that's a good way, but actually, and stress also raise our inflammatory factors in our blood, which also damage our heart.
Yes, correct. So if you, for example, let's say you feel stressed, sometimes you don't even sleep at night, okay, you're staying up late, so lack of rest, okay, lack of sleep is also one of the risk factors for getting the heart disease.
Yeah. Last one, we have metabolic syndrome.
Actually, metabolic syndrome is a condition where it's a compilation of all the signs and symptoms that we mentioned just now, including a big waistline. Okay, if you have a very big waistline, like for example for men, if you have a waistline of more than 36, okay, it actually put you at higher risk of getting this heart disease as well.
Yeah, so just now we mentioned about what is the risk factor. Now we might want to know what kind of changes we could make to get a healthy heart to prevent we getting into this heart disease.
Correct. So we know that some factors that we cannot control, like our age, okay? When we age, our MGN also will go down. But there are some factors that we can control, for example, smoking, drinking alcohol. So what are the things that we actually use, okay? What are the things that we can do to reduce our risk of getting this heart disease?
Yeah, so today we are going to further on the nutrition prospect.
Yep.
So now we have good nutrition for healthy heart. First yep. one, we have soluble and insoluble fiber.
Okay, so fiber, okay, I believe we are not alien to it because we know fiber actually makes our gut healthy. Okay, so when you have constipation, you need fiber. Okay, but in fact, fiber, there are two types. Okay, mm-hmm, one of it will be soluble fiber. The other one, it will be insoluble fiber. Now, maybe people ask, what is this soluble and insoluble fiber? Okay, imagine sometimes when you eat vegetables, mm-hmm. when you chew and chew and chew and chew, if you don't swallow it, eventually it will form a mess of this fiber material. So this is actually called the insoluble fiber, all right? Whereas for soluble fiber, it's like, for example, if you take oats, mm-hmm. all right? When you make oats and then, or you prepare our oatmeal products, you usually notice that if you leave it for quite some time, it will form like very sticky, gelatinous material. So this sticky thing is actually what we call as the soluble fiber. Now, how does these two fiber actually helps in helping our heart?
Yeah, so actually, in our gut, we know that soluble fiber will form the bark.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it will motivate the bowel movement.
Right.
And also the insoluble one will like soften your tooth, easily to pass out.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have a good digestive system, when your mm-hmm. gut health is healthy, your whole body also healthy, and your whole body will also have lower cholesterol level, mm-hmm. lower blood pressure,
yes.
and also a lower blood sugar, especially when you're eating fiber food. Mm-hmm. It has a very low glycemic index.
Yes, correct. Yeah. So even soluble fiber, for example, from oats, from barley, actually they go into the stomach, okay, they go to the digestive tract, the intestines, it actually helps to bind to the bile acids, okay? When it binds to the bile acids, and then these bile acids will be removed from the body. Okay, what are these bile acids made from? Cholesterol, okay? So when the bile acids being removed from the body, that's where the cholesterol from our entire body, okay, our blood vessels will be circulated and then to make new bile acids. So in a way, actually helps to reduce the cholesterol from our body, all right? So aside from oats, barley, okay, what are the things that also have this soluble and insoluble fiber?
Mostly from the whole grains and mm-hmm. also other whole grains like brown rice, buckwheat, and also we
yes.
have fruits like banana, mm-hmm. apple. These are the source of the soluble fiber.
Yes, correct. So always eat more whole grains, okay, eat brown rice, red rice, okay, purple rice, black rice, any kind except white rice, okay, mm-hmm. because it has a higher fiber content, alright? So next one, what else do we have?
Next one, we have omega 3 fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids, and also mm-hmm. including polyunsaturated fatty acid. Any
yes.
kinds of unsaturated fatty acid.
Yes, so this omega 3, as we know, is very good for our brain, also very good for our eyes,
yeah.
but in fact, it is very good for our heart because it actually helps to reduce triglycerides from our blood. Okay, triglyceride is actually one of the fatty material that floats in our blood.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have too much of triglycerides in your blood, that's where you have a higher tendency to have blood clots, okay, in the blood vessels also. Alright? And what about this monounsaturated fatty acids? It's actually omega-9. Alright? It is also one of the healthy nutrients to keep your heart healthy as well. So what are the food options that we have?
So for this unsaturated fatty mm-hmm. acid, we have avocados,
mm-hmm.
we have seaweed, we have olives, we have flaxseed, chia mm-hmm. seed, or any vegetable oils.
Yeah, so any kind, as long as, like, for example, sometimes we like to use avocado to make milk smoothie,
mm-hmm.
okay, or we want to use avocado, we just add a little bit of honey, you can make a healthy spread in
toast.
Our yeah toast, in our bread. So it's actually very, very healthy options of getting the omega-9 instead of just getting those butter
mm-hmm.
or even those synthetic margarine, okay, which could be very high in saturated fat and also trans fat, right?
Yes.
And like, for example, flaxseed or flaxseed oil is actually a very healthy source of plant-based omega-3. So we know that plant-based omega-3, aside from keeping our heart healthy, it also helps to reduce inflammation
yeah.
in our body. So actually helps to maintain a healthy circulation in our entire system, all right?
Yes. The next one we have folic acid and niacin.
Niacin.
This is vitamin B.
Yes, vitamin B. And we know that niacin is vitamin B3. So what are the functions? Actually helps to improve the energy metabolism in our body. When we eat, like when you eat a food, okay, the food doesn't just go in and then or start to have all the reactions and help to give you the energy. Actually needs a lot of these other nutrients to work together to give you the energy, including the folic acid and niacin. And we know that folic acid and niacin, if you are lacking in folic acid and niacin, you may have one of the compound called the homocysteine. And this homocysteine actually will increase your risk of getting this heart disease as well.
So for what this we have for vitamin folic acid, we can get from mushroom, mm-hmm. we can get from nutritional yeast. We all know that breweries and nutritionists, they are very rich in vitamin B complex.
Yes.
And also actually in cooked whole grains.
Yes,
for
correct.
For grains like red rice, mm-hmm. black rice, all those barleys and leafy vegetables.
Yes, we know that folic acid, okay, we need it. We can get it from greens, okay, any type of greens, you name it, spinach, kale, broccoli, okay, yeah. all these contain very high folic acid content, or even like black beans, okay, mm-hmm. Soy beans, they also contain very high amount of folic acid. Alright.
Okay, next we'll proceed to magnesium. You know that magnesium is, if you don't have enough magnesium, mm-hmm. you have a poor sleep quality, isn't it? But magnesium is also important for our heart health because it helps to control our heartbeat.
Oh, okay.
For a regular heart rhythm.
Yes, so if you have a lack of this magnesium or even potassium, you may have some issues with the heartbeat or even the muscles, okay? Mm-hmm. Because our heart is made from muscles, right? So the muscle will also need the good source of this magnesium to keep it pumping, right? So what are the good sources of magnesium?
Yeah, we have nuts, we have mm-hmm. beans, we wow. have this pumpkin seeds, mm-hmm. almond, and also dark chocolate.
Wow, it's yeah. a good news for a lot of people, especially ladies, I suppose, because we all love chocolates. Why? Because chocolate, aside from keeping you happy, it is also a very good source of this magnesium. So it actually helps to keep your heart healthy. And chocolate also contains the cocoa polyphenols, which is a type of antioxidant, yes. and it also keeps your blood vessels elastic. Okay, elastic, and it actually promotes a better blood flow to your heart, okay, to your body, and including your brain. Alright.
Yeah. So when you're choosing for chocolate, try mm-hmm. to opt for dark chocolate, which is made from the pure cocoa butter, because
yes.
some kinds of chocolate maybe they will made from those artificial cocoa butter or mm-hmm. those vegetable oil, which is not good for our heart.
Yes, correct. Some people say, I also got eat chocolate. I eat yeah. milk chocolate.
Different thing.
Different level, okay? So you have to look for those that have very high percentage, for example, 70%, 80%, even 90% cocoa. Alright? So if you want to know more, you can actually tune into our previous episodes of sharing. We have actually talked about chocolates as well, okay? For your health benefits. And also remember, when you're choosing nuts, seeds, always get those that are, for example, roasted. Okay, without any additional salt or sugar.
Yeah.
Okay, because some people think I got take nuts also, I got take walnut, almond, but it's all packed with sugar and salt. So actually defeats the purpose of taking the nuts and seeds. Okay, go for natural, organic or unroasted, alright? So without any additional salt and sugar.
Mm. Yeah, next we have plant antioxidants, for example, like quercetin, lycopene, anthocyanins, and many more. We know that our heart actually, the free radicals can damage any kind of cells or vessels mm-hmm. and body in it. So, same goes to the heart. So, by ingesting more antioxidant rich food, can help to remove those free radicals from our body.
Yes, correct. For example, sometimes when we cut a banana, for example, okay, when we cut a banana, when we leave it open in the air, okay, for quite some time, the banana will turn brownish.
Yes.
Alright, that's because of the free radicals in the air actually gets into the browning of the banana. But when what we do, we apply lemon juice. Okay, over the banana. So lemon juice contains natural antioxidants like vitamin C.
Yeah.
So this actually helps to protect the banana, the open banana, from browning.
Mm-hmm.
So this is actually the concept of antioxidants. So the same thing, our body is constantly exposed to a lot of these free radicals. For example, from the outside we have the sunlight, yes. the UV rays, the car, exhaust fumes, okay, even the food that we eat. Inside they may have a lot of these preservatives, chemicals, okay, a lot of these things that we don't even know how to pronounce, okay, in our food. So this can actually lead to all these free radicals and damage our body. Right?
So we have few types of antioxidants here, mm-hmm. like quercetin is normally comes from onion, mm-hmm. buckwheat, and lycopene, we know that it's from the tomatoes. Or red thing, watermelon, mm-hmm. papaya,
mm-hmm.
and anthocyanins is from the purple, black, or blue color food, for example, purple sweet potato, mm-hmm. purple Chinese yam, blueberries, blackberries,
purple cabbage, yeah. okay, purple onion, any kind that is purple, or even dark blue, alright? Or even sometimes when we recommend people to eat, like for example, they eat capsicum, okay? Mm-hmm. Don't just eat green capsicum.
Okay, many colors of capsicum.
You can take yellow, you can take red, okay? This all comes with different types of colors. So we recommend you to take at least 5 colors a day because it actually comes with a lot of different types of plant antioxidants, all right?
And last, we have potassium. So it's quite similar with the function of magnesium, also control our heartbeat, our heart rhythm. So for potassium rich food, we can, there's a lot of potassium rich food around us. For example, mm-hmm. we have dry fruits like apricots, we have bananas, mm-hmm. we have spinach, we have the sweet potato, mm-hmm. we have broccoli. So for apricot, normally those we found in the markets mm-hmm. were really golden, isn't it?
Yes, those golden apricots, right, they actually spray with this sulfur dioxide.
Yeah.
The more sulfur dioxide actually is a type of preservative and actually prevents the apricots from browning. So of course you will say sulfur dioxide is a safe preservative, but if we consume too much, or for those people who are allergic to sulfur dioxide, they may have some irritations, allergic reactions. So of course if you can choose the organic apricots,
yeah, unsulfured,
okay, unsulfured ones, so that we reduce the exposure to sulfur dioxide. And actually this potassium, right, it is actually, actually works together with this magnesium to keep our heart healthy. And the thing is, actually helps to remove extra sodium from our body.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Sometimes we know our Malaysian, especially Chinese, we cannot resist salty foods. Okay,
yeah.
We have to put a lot of this salt, soy sauce, tomato sauce, okay, oyster sauce, hey, hoisin sauce, a lot of things.
Sauce a lot.
Yeah, we learn sauce a lot. Okay, we learn dipping sauce, everything lah. So we actually put ourselves at a higher sodium intake or salt intake. So the more salt you take, the more sodium you take, actually put you at higher risk of high blood pressure. And remember just now when we say high blood pressure puts you at higher risk of heart disease, okay, or heart attack. So by taking more greens, okay, by taking more potassium, it actually helps to reduce or flush out the extra sodium in our body. All right. So remember, don't forget to take at least one banana every day.
It's very easy lah. One banana, just peel and eat. No need to cut out or
yes.
What kind of very hard preparation method.
It's super easy, and banana is one of the super rich foods that are very high in this potassium. So if you need potassium, choose banana. Of course, there are other food also, for example, soy milk. Okay, soy milk is also a very good source of this potassium as well.
Yeah, so remember, for your dietary advice, try to eat a raw variation of fruits and vegetables mm-hmm. with many types of colors. And remember, each day, at least take 5 servings of vegetables and fruits,
mm-hmm.
which made up of 3 servings of vegetables and mm-hmm. 2 servings of fruits. But how do we know is 1 serving is how much?
Okay, 1 serving of fruit is, for example, like we say apple, so it's like 1 whole apple. Of course, it's not a Fuji apple. Lah. Fuji
mm-hmm.
apple is about 1.5 to 2 servings already. So the other one may be like orange, what we call this, maybe watermelon is like 1 slice,
yeah,
okay,
pineapple
1 slice, okay, or even like grapes have about 8 to 10 pieces, okay, so that's 1 serving. Or vegetables is about 3 to 4 tablespoons of cooked vegetables, okay, so that's 1 serving. Okay, any type of green leafy is fine, alright, as long as you take at least 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruits every day.
Yeah, aside from fruits, try to manage your lifestyle, having a healthy lifestyle, don't smoke, don't drink if you can, and also sleep early, don't burn midnight oil always, and also have a happy emotion.
Emotions, okay, your feelings, because don't forget, stress actually affects a lot of things, including
yeah.
your emotions and your heart. So if you want to have a healthy heart, remember, heart is not a liver, okay? Liver is a silent organ, but heart sometimes gives you a lot of symptoms, okay, a lot of demo. So if you already having some strain, okay, in the heart, for example, as we said, shortness of breath, okay, you feel very tired, you know, just taking a few flights of stairs, you already feel very tired. So it's time for you to wash out, okay, your heart health, okay?
Yeah, even you already have heart attack before, to prevent you to have a second
heart attack,
try to manage your, maybe if you have high blood pressure, high blood glucose, high cholesterol, manage them so you won't so easily get into another second
yes.
heart attack.
Listen to your family members, okay, when they ask you to cut down on salt, cut down on oil, please do so, because we only have one heart. And you lose it, yes, some people say I can get heart transplant, okay, but believe me, heart transplant is very hard to get in Malaysia. So you only have one heart, please take good care of it.
Yeah, so if you have any question, any heartfelt sharing, what to share with us,
yes,
you can leave your comments below. We, our nutritionist team will answer your question and also reply to your comments.
Yes, of course, if you like the sharing today, don't forget to share out, because we know Every single day, we have 50 Malaysians who die from heart disease or heart attack. So if you do not want to be one of the statistics, so please take good care. Share this with your family and friends or your relatives so that they can get benefits from this sharing today.
Yeah, so I think that's all today for our old health.
Yes.
So I'm Wenxin.
I'm Jeremy. So stay tuned to our next sharing on old channel. Till then, bye bye.